Dr. Sivaraman of inoindices.com. Hope you're able to hear me. Ladies and December 29th, we are going to have a single webinar for this particular week. Asian Session Live Market Analysis. Let me display the PowerPoint presentation. So it is Asian Session Live Market Analysis on December 29th between 5 and 5:30 GMT. So we will be doing a simple market tracking technique using the Live Market Quote page. I will give the link for the Live Market Quote page. You can open it in a browser and view the Live Market where exactly it is. So market is making some subdued moves. Let me focus the camera over that of the Live Market Quote page and display the quotes as you see in your browser. So it is currently at 1.4371. The low is 1.4356. The high is 1.4380. You come across a subdued move. The net change is 6 pips negative. So the time is 5:01 GMT. So we can track the market using the GMT time frame. So you'll be able to easily track the market on a 24-hour cycle basis instead of our local timings. Then GBP is also in a very tight range. Currently it is 1.6009 and 13 calls bid in the ask. Then the low is 1.5998, the high is 1.6012, and the next change is 10 pips positive. Yesterday you would have noticed that GBP was looking very weak and euro was looking very firm, and euro was holding around 1.44 area for a prolonged period yesterday, and the spread again was very low. And today you find the GBP spread is very low, whereas euro spread is around 25 to 30 pips. And because of this net change of 6 pips negative in euro and 10 pips positive in the case of GBP, euro GBP has made a net change of 9 pips negative. So it has come down from that of the psychological level 0.90. Then USD yen is holding around 91 area, and when it was around 88 to 89 area, many were thinking whether there is a potency for yen to go up. Now you find that yen is the one which is making significant gains, and now the gain is only 8 pips positive. So it is also holding around in a very tight range. 91.63 is the low, 91.76 is the high, and hardly about 10 to 12 pips of spread is seen, but it is holding near that of the middle level. So we have to watch and see how exactly they are going to take up USDN. So we will see the forecast as well as the market reading and try to relate them and find what could be the possible or the expected moves during this particular day. Then USDCHO, which is one of the denominator currency, 1.0357 is the low, current level, 1.0357, 1.0360, and the low is 1.0348, the high is 1.0365, the net change is 10 pips positive, and so when euro has made a net change of negative 8 pips, CHF has made a net change of 10 pips positive, so you find a regular moves are happening. So USDCHF is expected to gain more if you relate it to that of EURCHF. Cross EURCHF, current level is 1.4883, 1.4886 area, 1.4874 is the low, 1.4891 is the high, the net change is positive 5 pips. So when CHF has gained more or almost equal to that of EURO, you find the EURCHF gains slowly. So EURCHF was doing a downward stop and last Friday as well as on Monday, and today it is expected to gain level. So this is how you can just relate the majors which are associated with that of the cross formation and euro, USD and USD CHF. When you compare it, we'll be able to identify what is the expected move in the case of the respective crosses. So, and also the net change will indicate as clearly whether they want to take it upward or downward. So you find that euro net change is 6 pips negative now, and the net change in the case of USD CHF of 8 pips positive. So still it is on the higher side. As such, you find euro CHF is going up. Similarly, in the case of yen, I told you 91.70, it is holding. And when compared to that of euro yen and GBP yen, you find both are showing a net change of 5 pips and 17 pips respectively, euro yen and GBP yen. And so it has showed all the lower levels last week, and we are expecting them to gain moderately during this particular week. This is the last week of this particular year. The volume has really come down drastically. As a result, you find that the currencies are making lesser spread and also lesser net change conditions. So they are all good swing trade opportunities, not ideal for position trade. In the swing trade also, we can aim about 30 to 40 pips profit, sometimes about 60 to 70 pips profit when there is a good going happening in the market. Otherwise, you are not expecting any significant rise or the drop when the volume is low, similar to that of the holiday condition. Then, in the case of the commodity pairs, USD CAD has not gained significantly. 1.0429 is the low, 1.0443 is the high. The net change is 10 pips positive. And in the case of Australian dollar, net change is 10 pips positive. So, which indicates that they wanted to make the contrarian move. So, normally, USD CAD has to show a net change negative and Australian dollar has to show a net change positive in order to show that they are wanted to make the USD weakening move. Whereas you find, as far as Canadian dollar is concerned, USD weak, USD strengthening move is seen. As far as Australian dollar is concerned, USD weakening move is seen. So this is a typical contrarian move. They are doing it during the Japanese session. So they wanted to focus more on the crosses again today because they find more stops there, more earning potency in the case of crosses when compared to that of the majors. So sometimes they will make very quick move in one or two currencies, their major currencies, mainly to handle the crosses. But otherwise, they are expected to hold those currencies, especially the USD yen. They might be holding it today just like that for some time in order to handle the yen crosses. So it is the second day of the week. So obviously, they will be making a little more move when compared to that of yesterday. So let us see how exactly they are taking up the market. So before going to that of the market reading, let me focus the camera over that of the PowerPoint presentation again and display the expected market moves for today. So expected market moves for the three sessions of today. Japanese session swing and slide moves are expected in the case of euro and GBP. European session, a quick rise is expected from that of the low, and higher level swings will be seen during early European session. Then from mid European session, slide moves are expected, and during US session, the slide is expected to continue downward till about 15 to 16:30 GMT. Then subsequently, the firming up move will be seen towards close of the day, towards close of US session. So it is the last week of the month. Volume based move could be seen. So normally in the market, when the volume is very low, in order to attract volume, the players will also try to make wider spread. So obviously, in the absence of volume, they will try to make wider spreads or make very quick up and down move, which could trigger the emotional traders to enter into the market. Okay, so during Japanese session, swing and slide moves are expected. And during the European session, yes, brief rise during the start around 8 to 8:30 GMT, then higher level swing up to 10:30 GMT, then slide is expected till 14 GMT, then continuation of the slide during the gap time and the early US session are expected. From 16:30 GMT, the firming of moves could be seen till 21:30 GMT. So the volume based moves is a very interesting aspect in the market. Normally, that players try to wait for the traders to enter into the market. If the traders hesitate enter into the market, then they will make some quick moves using some rumor. Thereby, the market will start making quick moves that will be done using the circular trades. Then the traders will think that, okay, the rumor is the truth. And obviously, they will try to enter into the market and gradually the volume will pick up. So it is like a gambling den wherein when the people are just spectators and they are not willing to bet the money and things like that, they will keep their own people to play and try to earn money during that play. So when they try to do this sort of trick and the people who are watching that, spectators might also get that emotional feel that why not I also make a bet and see what I can earn out of that. Then when they start betting it, first time they may earn, then subsequently they will lose. This is the normal strategy you come across in the case of the gambling den. So market also has to be triggered in similar ways. So you will come across that sort of triggers during this particular day today or tomorrow being the midweek. Then they will talk more about the year end and say that, okay, Euro might go higher in a very big way, then probably people will try to buy or they will try to sell. And that sort of activities will be seen. So watch for such moves and don't think that the market will be subdued forever. Okay. Let me just display the other slide, namely the initial lows and the highs seen for today and how exactly the market is currently handling those highs and the lows. Euro formed the low of 1.4356, which is intact, and currently Euro is around 1.4367 area, and the high is 1.4380, which is much lower than that of yesterday's holding level of 1.44 or 1.4398 area. And similarly, in the case of GBP, 1.5998 is the low, whereas yesterday's low was much lower than this, around 1.5940. And the high is also 1.6004 was the initial high, and it has breached the high. 1.6012 is the current high, so which indicates that they could make an upward stop and or make one extended rise in the case of GBP and a downward move in the case of Euro, in order to handle Euro GBP cross or drop Euro GBP cross. Then in the case of CHF, 1.0348 is the low, 1.0365 is the high. There's a typo. 0365 is the high, and both are intact, and they could breach the high and go above them. Currently, the market is staying in the middle level, 1.0357. Then in the case of USD Yen, 6163 is the low, which is intact, and 9163 is the low, 9176 is the high, both are intact, and you could come across that USD Yen cutting the high and going up a little bit and come down again when Euro and GBP are making the slide, because that is indicated very clearly by contrarian moves seen in, shown by USD CAD and USD AUD. So you have to watch the commodity pairs, and when the commodity pairs display the contrarian move, understand that they intend to make the contrarian move during this particular session. Then subsequently, when they make similar contrarian moves during the European session, understand that they could make contrarian move, and during such contrarian move, when GBP is rising, don't try to bet on Euro. And when they make a contrarian move, rise GBP and drop Euro, in order to drop Euro GBP, if you try to buy Euro, then probably you may not be able to book profit in that. Then when they make the USD weakening move or the USD strengthening move and try to enter into the market, not during the contrarian moves. When they make contrarian moves, they are all good times to enter positions in the crosses. Then, as far as Australian dollar is concerned, 0.8858 is the low and 0.8879 is the high. So, you find that 8871 was the initial high and they formed a new high, 8879. So, which also indicates that they wanted to rise Australian dollar as well as Canadian dollar during this particular day. Then they will make contrarian move for some time, then subsequently make regular move. Don't think that throughout the day they will make contrarian move, and don't try to bet on that. So you have to watch every time, then it change. That will give you an indication how far they are going to do the contrarian move. Then when they start making a reversal of it, that is either USD strengthening or USD weakening move, try to focus on that specific type of moves. So this is how we have to read from time to time the intentions of the players and take trading decisions rather than simply using any type of forecast. Then USD CAD, and also very important thing is you need to console, you need to read all the six pairs simultaneously. Only when, then you will be able to understand how they intend to make the moves in the market, rather than focusing on the currency in which you are trading and ignore rest of the currencies. So instead, if you watch all the four majors and the two commodity pairs, you will be able to really understand the market moves they intend to make. And that is what invariably happens when you look into the chart. You might focus only on one chart, or you will read one chart and go to the next chart and things like that. By the time the moves would have happened in the market, you may fail to recognize their intentions, their true intentions. There might be some apparent intentions expressed in the market, and what is visible in the market is not true. So you have to keep that in mind and take trading decisions. And in the case of USD CAD, 1.0429 is the low, 1.0443 is the high, and which is intact. So which clearly indicate that USD CAD they want to hold, and the AUD they wanted to rise. They cut the high, then subsequently they will rise USD CAD and drop AUD. So this is what the expected moves. So in the case of Australian dollar, they cut the high, so they intend to go above that of the high. And now if you see that they are still holding above that of 88.71 for more than 30 minutes, so which indicates that they wanted to rise Australian dollar now. Then whereas in the case of Canadian dollar, they are not cut the low correspondingly, which indicates that they want to make a rise in the case of Canadian dollar also. So they will rise Australian dollar and Canadian dollar to start with, then make one quick rise in the case of Canadian dollar and start dropping Australian dollar. Once Australian dollar comes below that of 88.71, then it will go to that of 88.58 very quickly, and then the drop will be very strong. So this is how you identify the pivot points, and the pivot point estimates and also the supports and resistance are all derived based on the high and the lows set for the day. But when they are all related to that of the previous day, sometimes you will find the moving averages working, and sometimes when there are intraday trend reversals, which will give the false breakout for you. So there comes the difference. Hence, I have developed the algorithm with which I'll be able to recognize the market moves and also give you the identity or the idea how to recognize what could be the expected moves in the market using the live market code page. Use that effectively and focus only on that. You'll be able to develop the insight. And if you, it is a question of developing faith. So if you have the full faith, then you will be focusing only on that. And if you don't have full faith, you might be using other reference materials, things like that, rather than the live market code page or the price action. Then invariably you will find that it is not working, it is working, and that sort of dynamic conditions will come. And that may continue to prevail in your mind. As such, you will find it very difficult to take trading decisions. Or probably you might see the visible opportunities, but you may not be able to take positions. So in order to avoid it, stick on to any particular method or a pattern which is really giving you a profit. So focus on the statistical analysis or charts and things like that. Try to do demo trades using a live demo trading platform, and focus on the live market code page and also the market reading, and try to do the trades in a demo trading platform and see which is working really for you. And accordingly, you can take decisions, because the trading decisions, depending upon the time you are spending in the market, then also the amount of usable margin or equity you are using it in the market, the amount of risk you are taking in the market, and finally, the nature of the trading platform, whether the trading platform is making their own stop-ins or the trading platform is giving a slippage on sometimes the delayed goods, etc. And also whether they have the hedging facility, trailing stock facility. And these are all the things you have to take into consideration before taking trading decision. Simply using any type of forecast, any type of system statistical analysis to try to do it, probably the platform may not be cooperating with you and they may not be able to give you the fill. Probably they may just give a runover and or they may just give a slippage. So you should be able to take into consideration all the practical difficulties in trading and keep it in mind so that it doesn't give you any surprise. And some of the trading platform, when you keep even far high the stop and things like that, they might try to hit the stops. And offline trading they might show. And there are so many practical difficulties and you have to keep all those things in mind before entering the trade. The best way to avoid the confusions is only take one position at a time, one single lot if it is equity is more than $30,000, or one mini lot if it is around $5,000 to $10,000 as the equity, and try to book profit in that position. Focus on the position, read the market, but focus on the position. Then book profit in that position, then subsequently think of another position. If you try to do it that way, every day you should be able to earn about $50 to $100. Still, it will be a large income for you. Rather than focusing on the forecast and try to do over trading, trade many positions out of greed that I want to earn back about $1,000 in a day or earn about $5,000 in a day. Try to take maximum permitted positions. Permitted for that usable margin. If you try to take it, then the market moves against you, even 50 pips, it will attract margin call. So if you have the hedging facility, if you have that facility to place the stops, and you have to take into consideration all those things and take very less position in order to consistently earn from that market. It is not that when you take more positions, you will be able to earn more, because greater that award, the greater the reward, the greater the risk also. But you try to take an optimal risk because it is a hard-earned money. You cannot just like that gamble with that money in the market. You try to see that you are able to consistently earn from that market. Let it be even 20 pips, 30 pips, doesn't matter. In the long run, once you develop the style of trading, you can increase your quantum of exposure and usable margin will also increase. Then once the usable margin increases, it will give you enormous confidence that, okay, if at all I lose that, it will be out of my profit, not my hard-earned money. And similarly, if you are really a smart trader, then once the equity becomes double, you withdraw your initial investment from that of the market and trade with it at the profit, you will find your confidence level will be extreme and you will be able to really trade. Even if you lose, you will not repent or you will not, it will not trigger your emotions badly. So these are all the ideas you should take into consideration before going for the trading for earning. So let me just minimize the PowerPoint presentation and focus the camera over that of the live market quotage and take up the questions which are asked here. Okay, Smith has got a question. Do you think GBP has finished the lower level consolidation and start to rise? Yeah. So GBP is expected to revisit the low 1.59 area by late US and US session, and probably from tomorrow onwards you will come across a significant rise in GBP, and that rise could be more when compared to that of euro for year end. What is your current reading on gold? Eric has got a question. Gold has drastically come down from that of 1,228 level, and it is expected to, it is trading around 1,100 level. It is trading below that of 1,100, the psychological level. and come above that, that may trigger an emotional feel or a bullish feel, but gold is expected to drop and it is expected to come to 1087 and subsequently a drop to 1067 and 1035 and it will come closer to that of 1000 by early next year. So whenever the rise happens, try to take a sell position, but try to keep stop to limit the risk, because the risk is very great in the case of gold trading. Volume has come down, so they could make about $20 to $30 swing, so you should not be wiped out. Okay. JD has got a question. Before the year beginning falls drop, do you expect GBP euro to have considerable rise? Yes. So the first week and the second week of Jan, I'm expecting the drop in the case of euro and GBP, and also drop in the case of USD Yen. Then subsequently the rise is expected. So I will give by 15th of January the focus for the year 2010 for all the four majors and the two commodity pairs. At that time I'll display the chart for euro also, how exactly euro is expected to behave, but I'll not be able to display for all currencies because they are all given to the paid members. So I will still show euro chart and you can take screen print of it, or it will be recorded and you can view it subsequently. And I'll also give the expected levels. They are all weighted moving average levels. From there you can take them. What is your view regarding USDN this week? USDN is expected to revisit 90 area and then probably close around 92 to 93. There could be a quick rise during the last day of this particular year in the case of USD Yen. Okay, Amir has got a question. What is your view on euro for January? That's what I explained. Euro is expected to make a drop and they could rise it to about 1.45 to 1.46 area. It depends upon the volume on 31st. And subsequently, I'm expecting a drop for 2 weeks during January, in the early January. Then subsequent rise could happen. Probably at that time, they may breach 1.42 area and go a little more lower to 1.41 area intraday and then make the rise. Okay. Do you think that S&P 500 will start to drop after the first week? See, as far as the stock market is concerned, stock market is expected to hold high till February and subsequently you will come across very significant drop in the case of stock market. You will be surprised that the economic data might be good and things like that, but stock market will be correcting and euro and GBP will be rising. So the earlier comparison, whenever the stock market goes up, euro goes up and GBP goes up, that story will go away. And probably they will say that whenever stock market rises, USD then USDN is expected to rise. That sort of stories will emerge out. Does the year beginning falls drop will start right away from the start of the year, or they will take some time before doing that? So obviously they will make 1 or 2 days consolidation, because first happens to be Friday, which is a holiday for most of the trading platform providers. So you may not come across much moves similar to that of 25th to what they have done. And when the platforms declare holidays and only very few platforms operate, then you may not come across big moves, because obviously the moves are mainly to earn from the market and simply making moves of no use. So obviously you have to see that the platforms start functioning from 4th. So probably for first 2 days there will be a consolidation and subsequently we will come across big moves happening in the market. So I have given that answer already. The view regarding GBP, GBP is expected to firm up. Probably it can go up to that level of 1.63 by 31st or year end level, and it is expected to revisit 1.59 area, 5930 or 5940 by US session, and then gradually you will come across the rise. And the rise in the case of GBP will be much faster when compared to that of euro in coming days. How do you expect yen crosses to behave during false year beginning drop? So as far as yen crosses are concerned, euro and GBP are expected to drop and USD yen is expected to make a swing in a consolidation mode. It could make a rise to 94 and then drop to 90. That sort of moves when they do. When they make contrarian move, you will come across double edge effect in the case of yen crosses. When they drop 100 pips in the case of euro, about 50 pips in the case of yen, then euro yen could drop about 150 pips. So keep that in mind. So they will make one more downward stop in the case of yen crosses before making the rise. Do you see gold below 1000? Yeah, gold below 1000 could be seen by third week of January. And by end of January, you will come across gold coming above 1000. So gold is expected to swing in the range of 950 to 1050 or 1100 for about 2-3 months. Okay, where do you see euro USD and GBP USD end of this week? That is end of the week and the end of the year are the same. I explained it already. They are expected to rise. Will euro USD drop much this week? No. Euro might drop today, but are not afterwards. Then JD, do you expect GBP to continue to 1.57? It is unlikely. I'm not envisaging that as per my forecast algorithm. Probably it can revisit 1.59. Do you expect Euro USD to cut yesterday's high today? No, Euro may not cut yesterday's high today. And probably they may try to go to that psychological level 1.44 area briefly during early European session. Hardly it's about 25 pips. 25 pips move is not a big deal. When GBP is rising about 50 pips, euro can gain about 25 pips. So the small swings, and I don't want to bet on whether it will cut yesterday's high and things like that. It all depends upon the volume and also how they wanted to lose or gain levels in the case of their respective crosses. Because if they want to make an upward stop in the case of euro GBP, then they will try to make one quick rise in the case of euro and show a psychological level of 1.44 and then subsequently draw. The overall move is very important and the fine tune high and the low, it is extremely difficult to identify. Do you expect euro USD to cut yesterday? Yesterday GBP, they made bigger moves compared to that of most pairs. Even London closed, London holidays. Little movement. How do you expect this pair to move today? And what level will you end of the year? That's what Abel, I have given the GBP level. It can revisit 1.59 area and then go to that of 1.63 area or 63 to 64 area by year end. When watching the majors and commodity pairs on the Live Market Quote page, as you said, you are watching to see which pair is starting to move compared to that of the others. Yes, you have to see the price action in every pair, where exactly you find the action starts. Then it will spread to other pairs. That is, euro may be negative, then it starts to cross over to the positive. So okay, when euro drops, the net change is negative, then it comes to that of 0-0 level, neutral, then it comes to positive. In that case, you can understand that after making a downward move, they are trying to make an upward move. Then that is what I explained in an earlier webinar also. When you see the net change, when they consistently hold the net change positive for more than 30 minutes, you can expect a swing of 30-40 pips in the net change positive level. Then once from the positive, if it comes to that of negative, then they will make about 20 to 30 pips or 30 to 40 pips net downward net change. That is bound to happen during the intraday swings. Okay, that is euro may be negative, then it start to cross over with a positive. This goes your signal that euro USD is one to watch. Is this correct? No, it is not that always you have to focus on euro. You have to focus simultaneously on all six pairs. So remember what are the levels you have seen in all the six pairs from time to time, or make a note of it and try to compare it. And for easy comparison, you have the high and the low. So make a note of the high, and after about 2 hours, you watch the high or the low, whether they are breached or not. So when exactly they are breaching is not important for us. Have they breached the high or the low is important. And subsequently, the next change, whether it has come from the positive to the negative, negative to the positive. So when you watch every 1 hour or every 30 minutes, if you are a full-time trader, or every 1 hour to 2 hours, if you are a casual trader, then you will be able to really get the overall picture without even looking at the chart. And once you spend less time in reading the market, you will be able to spend most of the time in trading. Then you will find that trading becomes profitable. Okay, Abel has got a question. Do you have any view on euro yen? That is what euro yen, I said that they are expected to make a rise today in the case of euro yen and GBP yen, as they are holding USD yen, and also you find GBP is net change positive, euro is net change negative. GBP yen could gain significantly when compared to that of euro yen, and subsequently they will reverse. As I given the forecast during the late European and the early US session, there is going expected drop in the case of euro and GBP, and also USD yen has very clearly indicated that they continue to do the contrarian moves. When USD CAD is also net change positive, AUD is also net change positive, then they wanted to make contrarian move. So expect a contrarian move most of the time and try to trade. Then you will find euro yen drop near that of a low. Low in the case of euro yen was 131.65, and probably they may make a small downward stop and about 30-40 pips below that of the low. At that time you try to pick up, then they will gain and go above that of the high. At that time book profit. Can you please show the slide? Yes, I will show the slide. Okay, expected moves for the today. During the Japanese session, swing and slide moves are expected in the case of euro and GBP, and you can anticipate contrarian moves as I indicated using Canadian dollar and Australian dollar. Then European session, a quick rise during the start of the European session. Probably they may come up to that of the high in the case of euro, breach the high in the case of GBP, then higher level swing for some time, then from 10:30 to 11 onwards, they will start sliding euro and GBP. And during the US session, a quick slide during the early US session, and then consolidate near the low up to 16:30 GMT, then firm up to first close are the expected moves for today. And after this drop today, I am expecting from tomorrow a good or a significant rise in the case of euro and GBP, and also USD yen as a contrarian move till year end. So I will be updating the forecast in the blog in the rest of the days. I will not be giving the webinars. From 4th January onwards, I will be giving the regular Asian session live market analysis between 5 and 5:30 GMT. Then we will talk about those currencies for the new year. So I take this opportunity to wish everybody a very happy holidays and happy new year 2010. And we hope to see you in the webinar by next year. Meanwhile, I'll continue to display in the blog the forecast and interact with you by giving replies to your questions. So I take this opportunity to thank everybody who have participated in the webinars and making this blog a great success. And I wish to continue to work with you and learn from the market, and also whatever I have learned, I will try to share it with you. See you all. Bye. Happy holidays.